Hello, everybody. Welcome to the very first episode of the Indian LCHF podcast. We welcome you. I'm your host, Natchi Lazarus, and here is my co-host, Tina.
Hi, this is Tina from Indian LCHF. I look forward to today's podcast, and let's see what we can learn today.
So today we are going to have a very, very interesting and very important first episode. We are excited about this as much as you are because this is a new thing for us. We've had tremendous support on YouTube, haven't we, Tina?
Yeah, we've got good support on YouTube and a lot of encouragement. But this is not just exciting, it's nervous as well because I'm not used to this at all. Let's see.
Yeah, so the way we're going to do this is very simple. We are going to, we're just going to ask questions. So I'm going to ask questions, which is an easy job for me. And Tina is going to answer. So I am the layman here.
The layman and the fat man.
Not so fat anymore. I used to be fat. By the way, we are doing this because this LCHF has been such a blessing for us personally. I have lost weight. I've lost almost 30 kilos since we started this. And our entire story is in the Indian LCHF website. If you haven't looked at it, I highly encourage you to look at it. And Tina reversed diabetes and so on. So that is why she's calling me the fat man. I'm still fat, not that fat, but I still have some way to go. So I'm with you on this journey. I think that's what is interesting about this, isn't it, Tina, that I'm still going through this.
Yeah, he's still not achieved you've still not achieved your target weight nor your target numbers. While it's very irritating for me, it might be exciting for you. But like you say, it's nice because then the people who are listening to it feel like one of us is like them, you know. So you're almost like one of the persons who's listening and who needs to know about this and who has probably the same questions that you have. So that way it's nice, but don't remain like this forever. I look forward to having you a slimmer man than now, at least. Yeah.
If you haven't yet figured out, you know that we are married by now. So Trina bears the, you know, the you know, all the problems that come with being overweight. So that is why she wants me to reduce, which is a good thing because I have the same struggles as most of you. In the sense, I'm a foodie. I love to eat. I find it very difficult to exercise my willpower. So I'm going to be sharing my side of the story in this podcast, and Tina will come from where she has been, where she has spent a lot of time researching and going through details to help me reduce and to help her reverse diabetes. And eventually, we have been able to help a lot of people reverse diabetes, lose weight. I'm jumping ahead. I'm not going to share all the stories this time. However, as we go along, we'll share a lot more stories. We'll have testimonies from people just to encourage all of you, you know. And the primary reason we're doing this is to help you, to encourage you, to educate you, because we believe knowledge is power. You shall know the truth and the truth will set you free. So we're going to talk about a lot of truth. So let's get into the show let me ask some questions. So Tina, today's show is about what is LCHF and why LCHF. You know, some of the audience listening may be already doing it. It's also helpful for them because it refreshes our memory. It takes us back to the purpose, if you may call it like that. But for many of us, it's also new. You know, many people might be just starting LCHF journey. They may be wondering how to do it. So from an Indian LCHF point of view, help us understand what in the world is LCHF.
LCHF is the abbreviation for low carbohydrate, high fat. So it is a diet, if you may use the word diet. Diet actually means the way we eat. It's not a restrictive, periodical, difficult kind of eating that we go follow for a few days. Diet means the way we eat normally on an everyday lifestyle. So LCHF, low carbo high fat, is a diet where we eat fewer carbohydrates, which are healthier carbohydrates, and we eat higher, we derive more energy and more fuel from good fats. So that is lower carbohydrate, low carbohydrate high fat, LCHF. That is what it means.
So when you say it's a diet, so is it, just going back to some basic questions, is it something that people follow just for a period of time, or, you know, should I do it for a long time? What does it look like?
It is a lifestyle. So it is something that you follow for the rest of your life if you want to have a healthy life and you want an optimal life. But it is not it doesn't have to be extremely restrictive and rigorous as you go forward in time. But let me be very clear in saying that by the word diet, it is not like a 2-week diet or a 4-week diet. No, it's not. It's a lifestyle. You change your entire way of eating for the rest of your life. But is it extremely restrictive and difficult to follow? No, it's not extremely restrictive. It is not difficult to follow. And once you achieve your target numbers of health, including weight and other numbers, which we shall explore in the coming podcasts, I hope, then it's not that restrictive. You can relax once in a while. You can feast once in a while. You can break the rules, you know, if I may use the word rules, once in a while. So it's not restrictive. It's easy. It's fun.
It's easy and fun. Those are the two words that I like a lot. So, and I assure you guys, like I told you, I'm a foodie. And this was one thing that has helped me keep this weight loss going for what now, 4 years now. So nothing else has helped me keep this weight away, right? Because I've been losing weight. I'm 42 years old and I've been losing weight since I was 18 years old. But I always gained back. I always gained back what I lost. I've lost 10 kilos in 2 months and then I lose it, gain it again in 1 month. You know, that kind of crazy things, because I was a athlete and so on. So I used to lose weight very fast and then gain it back because I was eating the wrong kind of food. So I just want to assure you, whoever is listening to me, I want to encourage you. This is not difficult. This is easy. This is doable. And this is something that can really give you, help you do this long term. So excellent. So that was the opening that I wanted to have. I hope that helps you. Now let's go a little bit deeper. Just to also remind you at this point, if you have any questions, email us podcast@indianlchf.com. That is podcast@indianlchf.com. You can send in your emails or you can DM us in almost all social media channels. You can just Google Indian LCHF, and you will find it. This is the show for Indians living all over the world, used to a certain kind of Indian food. So you can find us in Indian LCHF all over social media. Send us a DM, send us an email. We are very happy to answer your questions. All right, so let's move to the next question. So having defined what LCHF is, what are some of the basics that we need to know when we are thinking of LCHF? Some basic concepts.
Okay, what we need to know is we derive our energy, our fuel, from food. And this energy is from food can be classified as protein, fat, carbohydrate, and alcohol. Obviously, alcohol is not the go-to source, so let's not even consider that.
Really? How sad.
Forget I said that. Forget I even mentioned alcohol. So that leaves us with protein, fat, and carbohydrate. Now, our energy comes from these three. In LCHF, low carbohydrate, high fat diet, what we understand is that the body has to be fueled in the following distribution. The highest being fat. So 70% of your body's fuel must be derived from fat, about 70 to 80%. And 15 to 20% of the fuel energy necessary can be derived from protein. Only the remaining 5 to 10% of energy should be derived from carbohydrate. Now, when I mention percentages, please understand that these percentages are not translated into quantities like the regular image that we are used to seeing. We see a plate that is divided into three and, you know, one kind of food on one side, the other kind of food on one side, like a
pie chart.
Like a pie chart, yeah. Mm. So it's not like a pie chart which translates into amount of food. This is amount of energy. So when I say 70 to 80% of fat, it does not mean that 70% to 80% of your pie chart plate is filled with fat. No, it means 70 to 80% of the energy derived from food should be from fat.
Uh-huh.
So if you put 70 to 80% of fat on your plate, you cannot eat it. Forget the fact that you should not eat it. You cannot eat it because your body is constructed in such a way that you cannot eat so much fat. 70 to 80% of energy derived from fat means a small amount of fat, saturated fats, derived from animals or from plants. And then 15 to 20% of energy derived from protein, and 5 to 10% of energy derived from carbs. Now let me tell you what kind, it's not just quantity of carbs, it also means what kind of carbs. So carbohydrates play, the knowledge about carbohydrates plays a very important role in understanding LCHF. So when I say 5 to 10% of carbs, you don't say, okay, let me have a teaspoon of sugar, because that's like the worst kind of carb you can go to. In the LCHF diet, what you should understand is that your carbohydrate intake should be from healthy sources of carbohydrates, mainly vegetables, fibers. So vegetables are considered as a good source of carbohydrate, and some healthy flours, usually nut flours, we'll go into those details in further episodes. These are the sources of carbohydrates that you should consider. Not grains, not whole grains, not refined grains, not cereals, not sugars, but mostly plant-based, fiber-based carbohydrates.
Okay, excellent. So now I can just see our listeners coming up with a million questions, because you've just opened up a new can of, questions where, you know, you're talking about cereals, what kind of cereals, all those things. Guys, we will answer all those questions, send them to us, and eventually we will answer these questions in coming episodes as well. So we're going to talk about each of them in detail, what to eat, what not to eat. We are going to talk about what kind of food to eat a lot in the coming episodes. So hold on to your questions. In fact, you feel free to send it to us after this episode, and we'll try to answer them as much as we can. And so now we've covered two things, Tina. One is we've talked about what is LCHF, then we talked about some of the basics of LCHF. Now, why should we fuel our body with this in this different way? You're talking about fueling in three different proportions, three different types of things that we derive our energy from. So why should we do this? Why, in other words, we are transitioning, just as we've crossed halfway mark in this podcast timing. We try to keep it 20 minutes, guys. So almost we've just crossed a little over half. Now let's go to the area of why LCHF. So to start off, why LCHF? Why should we fuel our body in this new way?
Yeah, we are so used to listening for the past probably 70 to 80 years that we should fuel our body mainly from carbohydrates and avoid fats. But this new, supposedly new, because it's not actually new, I believe that this is the way our ancestors have been fueling their bodies.
Which hold on. Are you saying that LCHF was the way that our ancestors lived?
Yes, yes. Wow. Thousands of years ago, even probably several hundred years ago, they were almost LCHF, or even LCHF itself, because that's why we also use the terms primal food or paleo food, because that goes to the understanding that let's go back to the way the Paleolithic man would have had his food. So yes, LCHF is not old. It is old. It's not new. It's this low carb, low fat diet which has been recently spread and thing which is new. I'll say this is very old because look at the man who would have had to hunt for his food. He would have had to hunt for animals, and animals they would have had to eat with fat. And before the dawn of agriculture, there were no cereals that man ate. Man moved from place to place. He was nomadic in most circumstances, and he ate animal food and probably some seasonal fruits and vegetables. And you should understand that this man did not have a knowledge of which was poisonous and which was not poisonous. So he would have limited his intake, and it would have been seasonal. It's not like we now get refrigerated and preserved fruits and vegetables all through the year. That was not the case in our ancestors' lives. So you should understand that that didn't happen. And even after agriculture was a process in which, you know, you have a season of harvest, you have a season of planting, and it happened only twice a year probably, and we didn't have all the scientific advancements which could give us a faster yield. Like nowadays, I understand that it could be 3 harvests a year or 4 harvests a year, but that's not what happened earlier. And even as seeds, it was not highly processed. It was eaten with its hull. It was probably soaked overnight. The cereals were soaked overnight or something like that, and they were not processed like they are today. They are not refined like they are today. They are not polished like they are today. So what we ate even 70 years ago was different. What we ate probably 300 years ago was very, very, very different, and it was in all probability low carbohydrate, high fat.
Wow.
The past 70 years has made us low fat and high carbohydrate. And you can see the results in our health statistics. You see the number of young people dying from heart attacks and obesities and having all kinds of, and much cancer has also evolved in the last 50 to 70 years. So if you read a bit back and see how the causes of deaths and things like that, you will understand that LCHF was the way and should be the way going forward.
Yeah, so coming back to our question, so why should we fuel our body in this new way?
I'm sorry, Natchi, you are going to have to come back to the question often in all these podcasts because I'm going to go away and, you know.
Yes, boss, that's my job.
Talk out of topic and veer away from the main question.
No, but I think it's important for us to understand that this was the way, because many times people think this is a new thing, you know, so it's a fad, it's just come, somebody has invented it. So I'm glad we covered that. We will come back to it later. I want to talk about it a little more deeper in another episode. But yeah, I want to give our listeners today a feel of why we should fuel this in this new way. Why are you asking me to change?
Okay. The why, if we go to the scientific reason and how the body sees it is. Okay, let me go first to the why generally. Why generally is, look around you.
Mm.
There are more obese people than there were 30 years ago.
With all due respect, guys, we are not trying to hurt anybody. If anybody's, I'm overweight, I'm fat. So we are not trying to hurt anybody's sentiment. If anybody is feeling like that, we're not trying to, be hurtful, right, Tina? We're just stating facts. I mean,
no.
That's...
See, the thing with obesity is we look at it as obesity as the symptom, which is an overweight person or a fat person. But what I want to say here when I say obese person is obesity is a symptom.
Mm.
It's a symptom of ill health.
Mm.
It's a symptom of deteriorating health.
Mm.
It's a symptom of a fast approaching death.
Mm.
It's a symptom of a person if I may use the word, disintegrating faster than he needs to. I believe in long life and I believe in a high quality of life.
Mm.
And when I use the term obese, what I mean is this is a symptom that you're not having that long life and that you're not having that high quality of life. And I address the symptom because the symptom is visible and it is what is addressed in many other programs and institutions as well. And the sad fact is the symptom is addressed from the wrong angle. People are saying eat low fat and exercise more, and obviously that's not working. So that is why I address the symptom, and that comes and that brings me back to the general reason why.
Mm-hmm.
You asked me why.
Mm-hmm.
I'll go to the general reason first.
Mm-hmm.
And then the scientific reason. The
yeah.
general reason is, look around you.
Mm-hmm.
If low fat diet was working,
mm.
so many people would not continue to be obese. The numbers of obesity is increasing worldwide.
Mm.
It is an epidemic. It's an epidemic that is more dangerous than the coronavirus that we're having today, and more long lasting. This coronavirus will go away in a few weeks, in a few months, and scientists who are working hard on it, much respect to them, will come up with a vaccination. So that will go away, like so many other epidemics and so many other diseases that we've seen in the past, you know, that scientists have eradicated away with. But this epidemic of obesity and inflammation and people dying young from heart attacks and people having a very low quality of life where they are dependent on medicines from day to day to day, and chronic medication right from the age of 30, people are on medication till the day they die, till they are 70. And so when you look around and you see that this low-fat diet has not been working, then the general reason why should be like, if this is not working, let me find something else that's working. This has not worked in the past 70 years. See, when I was a kid, when I walked out on the road, I would see one overweight person or three overweight persons. In my class of 60, we had five overweight children. But now, in a class of 60, there are about 30 overweight children. Everywhere, when you go to the supermarket, you go to a public place, you see overweight people, inflamed people, sick people, people who discuss diabetes medications like they would discuss, oh, what's on the menu today? I'll have a few vegetables, this, and three tablets for lowering my sugar levels, and three tablets for my, to lower my blood pressure, and three tablets for this, and all these medications that are addressing other issues of inflammation. So if you look around, the general why is, look around you, low fat has not worked. It's time to open your eyes to something that has not worked and go to something that has worked.
So
that's to something that can work, sure. Something that has worked in the past centuries and something that can work. So yeah.
Yeah, so overweight is one area that, again, we'll definitely address this. I know that we are fully aware that overweight people, people who are overweight could have multiple reasons. And what we are talking about here is somebody not because of medical reasons or other reasons, or but just somebody who is overweight because of food intake and so on. So that is what we are discussing here. And I just want to go to other areas which could be the reason, like, maybe one or two other things that you want to talk about. And maybe we can take the scientific reasons later. But one is, look around you, overweight. What else could be some of the other general reasons for general well-being, or even diabetes, or any other reasons that you want to think of?
Yeah, LCHF diet is the one that can help you reverse your diabetes. So you don't have to take chronic diabetic medications till the day you die. It can help you reverse hypertension, so you're not on chronic hypertension medications till the day you die. It can help you reduce or not have heart disease. You see so many young people having heart attacks and going and getting a stent inserted. Like, it's a half day job. Oh, I just got myself admitted. I have a stent. And then 3 years later, they're having another stent. And then 3 years later, they're having another stent. And the more stents they have, they cannot have a bypass operation if they need it later on in their life. So this can give you freedom from diabetes, freedom from hypertension, freedom from heart disease. These are the three major symptoms of inflammation in your body. And then freedom from so many autoimmune conditions is achieved by having an LCHF diet, or even a little stricter still, a diet that is helpful for the gut. We'll go into all these details in further podcasts. But it is freedom from medication. So one of the most general reasons, and it should be, because why should you follow the LCHF diet? You can be free from chronic medication. You can have a healthy lifestyle. You can have a fulfilled life. And you can achieve your purpose in life. Instead of spending your time, money, effort, and energy on solving your health problems. Mm-hmm. You will not have these health problems if you're on an LCHF diet.
Yeah.
So there you go.
Awesome. So we've run out of time. We've exceeded our 20-minute budget that we have for time, but I guess that's going
to
happen.
That's what will happen when you talk to me. So whenever I start off, Natchi shows me the time, time up symbol. So when I'm with family or with friends and somebody even asks me a question, that's the end. Their ears are bleeding by the time I'm done.
Yeah, when somebody starts with the LCHF question, I ask them, oh my word, why did you switch on, So as you can see, Tina is very, very passionate about this, because guys, this is not our profession. We are normal people. Tina is not a doctor. We are not medical professionals. So I just want to give you a general, it's not just a disclaimer, but it's really something that's coming out of our heart. This is not medical advice. This is our advice coming from people who have been through, and we're putting this whole show together and our website and everything simply to help you. All right. This is just our experience. So we would say, please consult a doctor or a medical professional if you have any medical conditions and so want. This is not a general advice. This is not something that you take it. But, you know, of course, I sound like a disclaimer. But that is also the point. But what we're saying is this. You know, we're doing this because we want you to experience what we experience. In Tamil, there is a saying that says, Yam Petra Inbam, which means, you know, something that I experience, I want to share with the world.
Yam Petra Inbam Peruga Ivayagam. Tell the whole phrase, okay?
All right, there you have it. So that phrase simply means, you know, I have something good and I want to share it with the world. So that's exactly what we're doing here. So thank you for spending your time with both of us. We are going to do this every week. We look forward to it. This is a fun time for both of us as well. And our goal is to help you, equip you, answer your questions. So as I mentioned earlier, send us your questions, podcast at IndianLCHF.com. You can go to our website, IndianLCHF.com. We've got tons of resources there for you, which Tina has put together because of doing her research on this subject for with reading 40, 50 books or more than that. And, you know, you'll find a lot of information there. Thank you. We will see you next week with another episode. God bless you. Stay healthy wherever you are. Tina, you want to sign off?
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.